Hey, thanks for joining us. I'd like to introduce you to Amanda Corner from the AIM Overseas team. Hi. How are you, Amanda?
I'm good.
Great. Yeah. Thanks for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
Now, tell me, how did you end up here to begin with?
So, I originally found the position because my sister, Tash, works on the marketing team, messaged me the job link, and she said, I think you'll be really good for this job. And so I applied, and I don't think she actually told you guys that I was her sister initially.
No, she did. It was quite funny because I got your resume through, and I went, oh, Corner, that's not the most corners in this particular suburb you guys came from. There mustn't be too many of them.
Yeah, it's not common. No. So yeah, I applied for the job, and then 2 years later, I'm here.
Awesome.
So yeah.
And you are like our team coordinator, aren't you? Like, God, I don't know how we actually survived before you joined. You're super organised.
Oh, thank you.
Where did that come from? Where did like your organisational zest come from?
I don't know. I think my parents, mum and dad, I don't think they're the most organised. So, and being the oldest child, I feel like...
love you, mum.
Yes, love you, mum. I feel like I'm the most organised being the oldest out of everyone. So... I think it originally came from that, and I just like lists and I like organized. I like everything to be organized and laid out properly, so yeah.
What do you think is different about the way that we work at AIM Overseas compared to maybe other organizations?
That's a good question. Yeah. So, when I first started, I guess I came from a retail background and I wasn't sure what the vibe was going to be like, and I thought that not working in an office before, I thought it might be a bit hostile, but everyone's actually super down to earth and lovely. So, it's really easy to work, an easy working environment, I guess.
Yeah. I think we've got an awesome team, haven't we?
Yeah.
Everyone's so fantastic to
everyone's
be around.
Great, yeah.
It really gets you out of bed in the morning. You come in not just for the work, but you come in for the people.
So you wake up in the morning and you're like, oh, you're not like, oh, work. You're like, yay, work.
Totally. Yeah. Okay, and what about travel-wise? Where have you been?
I've been to overseas. I've been to Bali twice and I've been to America twice.
Mm-hmm.
And coming up a third time, actually.
Nice.
So in America, I've been to sort of the West Coast and I did exchange there.
Cool.
I did like San Francisco, San Diego, and then I did a high school exchange in Santa Barbara.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Santa Barbara, because we've got an organisation we work with up there, Entreport, who are amazing. Santa Barbara's an insane town.
It's such a pretty town.
Yeah.
It was amazing. It was actually it was a town called Lompoc just outside Santa Barbara, so not actually in Santa Barbara, but like we spent weekends there and stuff like that, so it was really beautiful, yeah.
Nice.
Amazing city. And then on the East Coast, I've been to New York, and then Florida, and then a little town called Jacksonville.
Cool.
So, yeah.
Do you have any favourite memories from all of those adventures?
Yes. One that comes to mind, my partner and I went to a NFL game in Jacksonville.
Oh,
and
cool.
It was for some random team, and they just couldn't understand how two Australians ended up in a game like that. So we were kind of the center of attention. It was kind of fun. Like, why are you here?
And football is insane in the US, isn't it?
Everyone gets so into it.
You can't believe it, can you?
Yeah, it's really good.
Awesome. Amazing. What else is on your travel to-do list then?
So everywhere, basically.
Yeah.
But I've got a wedding in July, so I'll be back in New York and Long Island. So,
amazing.
Hopefully we'll do a stopover somewhere along the way as well, but yeah.
Sounds good.
And then Europe and everywhere else that I want to go.
Awesome. And if you had the chance to chat with a student that was thinking about studying overseas, what advice would you have for them?
I would say, honestly, just do it. It's probably the best decision you'll make in your life. You'll come back a changed person, and you'll get so many experiences and so many happy memories out of it, and you'll be talking about it for ages, and you'll have bragging rights forever.
Bragging rights is a good thing. Awesome chatting with you, Amanda. Thanks for your time.